Hello viewers, today we are going to see about circular current loop as a magnetic dipole. Already we have seen the derivation of for magnetic field because of a current carrying wire. So that's what this derivation already we have seen in the earlier videos. So we have a circular loop carrying a current I and we are interested in the magnetic field at a distant point, say P. And the magnetic flux density is given by mu naught I r square divided by r into x square plus r square whole power 3 by 2. This relation already we have derived. Now suppose if this distance is very far and compared to r, this is very far. Therefore, x is very much greater than r. Assume that x is greater, very much greater than r. So in that case, this r will become negligible. So you can assume to be 0. X square into 3 by 2, 2 gets cancelled, you will get x cube. Now we know that the area of the circle is pi r square. Okay. Now you see that this is the radius r of the circular loop carrying a current I. Therefore, in the place of r square, this is equal to a. So r squared is equal to a by pi. Therefore, in the place of r square, we can substitute a by pi. So, a divided by pi. Therefore, the magnetic flux density will become mu naught I a divided by 2 pi x cube. Okay. Now, we are going to define a new term called magnetic moment, m, which is nothing but I into a. I is the current, a is the area of the circular loop carrying current. Okay. Therefore, we can write this equation as mu naught divided by 2 pi x cube. Same, this I into A is defined, is replaced by M, which is nothing but magnetic moment. So now you multiply this equation with 2 and divide by 2. Okay, multiply by 2 and divide by 2. So what will happen? Mu naught 2 into 2, 4 pi, 2M divided by x cube. So this is the final expression. We multiply by 2 and divided by 2 just to have a easy to remember, because in the electric field we saw that 2 into electric dipole moment divided by 4 pi into epsilon naught into x cube. Now if you compare both the equation, 2m magnetic field, you have twice the magnetic moment. Okay, here also twice the electric field dipole moment. Okay, right, here you have 4 pi, here also 4 pi, here you have x cube and here also you have x cube. So what's the difference? Now the epsilon naught permittivity is in the denominator, whereas permeability of free space is in the numerator in the case of magnetic flux density. So therefore there is a big correlation between electric field and magnetic field, and to remember this formula it will be very easy. That's why we do multiplication by 2 and divided by 2. Now we saw already in the electric field, magnetic moment in an electric dipole, we have seen that we have electric monopoles. Mono means single, one pole, but we don't have magnetic monopoles. So this is an important one mark question. Do have electric monopoles. Okay, monopoles means single charge, plus Q or minus Q. But we don't have magnetic monopoles, don't exist. But still research is being carried out. They are trying to find out whether monopole exists in magnetic fields. Okay, so this is an important one more question you must remember. And we have derived this derivation for magnetic field density because of current cancellation in the earlier videos, and now we made a relation between magnetic moment and the magnetic flux density, as we did with electric dipole moment connected with electric field. Okay, so that's all about this topic, circular current loop as a magnetic dipole. So we are interested only in finding out the magnetic dipole or magnetic moment. M is equal to I into A. Hope you have understood this topic. Thanks for watching. Nandri.